Hey guys, Sam Pardee here, recording a video for Channel Fireball. I'm playing with the Junk Aristocrats deck that's become slightly popular lately. Basically, this is a green-white-black deck now. Used to be a red-white-black deck that's focused on synergies with sacrificing creatures like Doom Traveler and now Young Wolf and Voice of Resurgence as the green additions. To generate value with things like Skurzdag High Priest, Tragic Slip, and Blood Artist. So this deck's pretty streamlined. It's a pretty low curve. We have Doom Traveler, Young Wolf, and Voice of Resurgence as the things that like to be sacrificed, and I guess Lingering Souls to some extent. Blood Artist and Skurzdag High Priest and Tragic Slip as the things that benefit from having, that get turned on by having creatures sacrificed, and then Cartel Aristocrat and Verals as the guys that do the sacrificing. Then we have Sorin to provide more tokens and to give us emblems to go with our ton of creatures. We also have Gavany Township, which is why we're running 25 lands in our deck that stops at 4 on the curve. Some cute new synergies are Verals and Cartel Aristocrat. You can scavenge up a big Cartel Aristocrat and then make it, you know, have protection from all their guys to make it unblockable, which is pretty sweet. Yeah, that's about it. The sideboard, we have Abrupt Decay as some cheap removal, Sin Collector for the spell decks, like the Sphinx Revelation decks, Deathrite Shaman, who is good against the graveyard decks, like Unburial Rites and stuff, Unflinching Courage as additional red anti-red cards, Garrick as another Planeswalker threat against the control decks, and also to kill like Fiend Hunters and opposing Blood Artists. And then a single Appetite for Brains is another card for the spell decks. So let's get to it. We would love to play first, and this hand looks perfectly good to me. Alright, so with a hand like this, I typically, depending on what we draw, I usually prefer to lead off with the Skurzdag High Priest, because it gives us more, chances to like draw a Doom Traveler and then a Sac Outlet and just play them both in the same turn and make a demon that turn. Although now it's looking like that's probably not going to happen, so I'm going to play the Voice of Resurgence, because basically we'd have to draw both a Doom Traveler and a Cartel Aristocrat, and obviously we don't have either, so we can't draw both next turn. So I'm going to play Voice and try to trade it for his guy. This is worse if he has Pillar, but it's kind of like if he had played a Stromkirk Noble, I'd think it was much more likely that he had Pillar in his main deck. I don't think it's that likely that a Experiment 1 deck also is playing Pillar. And I'm happy to trade here. I'm going to be playing so many guys that our Elemental's going to get huge. I'm just going to Lingering Souls and attack him for 3. Then next turn we can... Oh, shoot. I forgot about the Dryad Militant's ability. Alright, well, that was awful. I was thinking I'd play Souls this turn, and then next turn, High Priest. But that's okay, this is actually fine. Like, it still stops his Dryad Militant from attacking in any meaningful way. And then we can just play High Priest next turn. Like, I'm happy to trade a soul for the Dryad Militant, that's fine. Yeah, I think I might have actually just done that even if I had remembered the Dryad Militant isn't just a 1-mana 2-1. Alright, so he's going to shock himself again and add a Boros Reckoner to his board. That's fine. Ooh, Sorin's pretty good. So, I think what I want to do is just play Sorin, make an emblem and just hit him for 4 with our Lingering Souls. That way he still can't attack with Dryad Militant. He can, like, attack and kill Sorin with Boros Reckoner, but who cares? He's going to be so low on life at that point that it's going to be hard for him to get back into things. So I'm just going to do that. And if we kill his Dryad Militant with our Elemental, then we can just play and flashback Lingering Souls and have infinite power in the air. He might have Thundermaw Hellkite or something to try and get out of it, so I wouldn't flash it back, but he's under so much pressure now. Like, he's pretty low, and we're still at 20. He's gonna be hard-pressed to even attack with the Reckoner for fear of getting attacked back by the giant elemental. Rotting Core. Okay. And just the Dryad Molten is attacking. I think it is still worth it to trade just because I have another Lingering Souls that I want to cast. Even though this is trading our Elemental and our Sorin for his Dryad Militant. The Sorin did his work of getting us an emblem, basically. So he's shocking himself again to play Experiment 1, and we know one of the other cards in his hand is Rancor. Okay, so we know he has Rancor and an unknown card in hand. So I could put him to 1 this turn by playing Varal, shocking myself, and scavenging a voice onto a spirit. I would like to play in a way that doesn't lose to Blasphemous Act, if at all possible. Which I think is probably better to play Skirzdag High Priest and Lingering Souls. That way we don't flash it back and we can do some blocking on his turn. And we're still in good shape if he has Thundermaw. Although, if he has Thundermaw, he'd also have to rip a land. So I'm not too concerned. Alright, so he's Rancoring the Voice. That doesn't matter hardly at all. And then attacking with everybody. So, I think I'm going to trade a token for Experiment 1. And let's see, so if... Basically, I'm trying to figure out the ways we can possibly lose. If he has land, Blasphemous Act, and there are 5 creatures in play, then he could still kill us. So if we... If we block Experiment 1 and double block Voice of Resurgence, then that's no longer an out. And then what I'm trying to figure out now is if Land Restoration Angel would then be an out for him, which it would be, and it's much more likely that he has that, although it's pretty unlikely that he has an untapped land that doesn't cost him life. I guess it's not that unlikely. There's 8. Probably has 22 lands in his deck. I think I'm just going to make this block and be willing to lose to land Blasphemous Act exactly, if that's exactly what he has. It seems pretty unlikely, though. Because this beats Mizium, Mortars, Resto, most other things you could do, Hunt Master, whatever. Alright, good. Post-board, it's much more likely that he'll actually have a Blasphemous Act to cast. So, sideboarding-wise... I like Abrupt Decay. I typically like cutting Blood Artist because we want, like, Blood Artist is really good when we're trading resources, which is what we want to be doing in this matchup, but it doesn't actually make us any... It makes trading resources better for us, but it doesn't help us successfully trade resources, if that makes sense. Like, Cartel Aristocrat helps us successfully trade resources because we're, like, trading a spirit token to give it a protection from a color to hopefully, like, trade for one of his guys. So that's a trade that we're willing to do. Blood Artist makes that trade more profitable for us, but we don't need those trades to be more profitable. We just need them to be happening. So I like shaving Blood Artist out. I think Unflinching Courage is good. I think Sorin's also not very good in this matchup just because he's very slow, especially on the draw. And I like Garrick because he can kill if they have Fiend Hunter... If they have Avacyn's Pilgrim, there's just a lot of little guys he can kill. So that's how I'm on a sideboard.